If you're thinking about moving to Phoenix, but you're a little worried about how you're going to stay cool and entertained during our hot summer months, then this video is for you. I'm gonna be sharing all of the great summer activities we have here in the Phoenix area to keep you cool, keep you entertained, and survive the Phoenix summers. So let's get to it. My channel. My name is Braiden. If you don't know me, I'm a local real estate agent here in the Northwest Valley. I work with my mom and we are the Desert Charm Living real estate team, helping you find home in the desert. On this channel, we share all about the Northwest Valley real estate updates and lifestyle too. So if you're already living here and you're trying to find out more about the area or more about what's happening in real estate, or you're thinking about moving here, then make sure you hit subscribe. I'm releasing new videos every single week. So I think anything with water is the best way to stay cool and entertained during the summer months. Swimming, splash pads, slip and slide sprinklers, and visiting your local water parks or community pools. Anything with water is going to be a really great way to stay cool, stay entertained, and really make the most out of these hot summer months here in Phoenix. So your backyard may not have a swimming pool, but if you want to put one in or put an above ground pool, or even just buy a kiddie pool at, you know, Target or Walmart, that would be an option for you depending on what you're looking for. But if you're in a newer neighborhood, maybe you have a neighborhood pool that you pay for through your HOA, that could be a great option for you. Or you can go visit one of the local city pools. And there may be a fee attached to that. It depends on the city and where you live, but look into that. That's a great option. We also have a lot of splash pads around the valley. I have a post on my Instagram actually about splash pads and parks in the Northwest Valley that you can visit. So go check that out if you're on Instagram. And if you are looking to get a seasonal pass for the water park or even just visit a few times, we've got Hurricane Harbor in North Phoenix. We do have Big Surf out in Tempe, and we also have the water park at Arizona Grand Resort. So if you want to go visit one of those, Big Surf is closed right now in the summer of 2021, still taking extra safety precautions from COVID, but hopefully by next summer, 2022, they will be open again. And Hurricane Harbor, which is owned by Six Flags, they have really great summer rates for their seasonal pass right now. So if you're looking to go multiple times, it would be well worth it to get one of those. Phoenix also has a lot of great indoor playgrounds. These are, you know, a really good option depending on if your kids are smaller or bigger. You know, a trampoline park could be a good option. We've got a ton of those, you know, the Sky Zones and the trampoline and adventure parks that are indoors, and keeping your kids active but also, you know, entertained and not trying to just watch TV or play video games all day. And then we've got a couple of you know, indoor playgrounds and play centers that are, you know, theme based, or they've got, you know, life-sized playhouses for the kids in North Phoenix and Litchfield Park, and some in, I think, Central Phoenix and Scottsdale. So if you're willing to drive a little bit further, if you're not in those exact areas, that can be really fun for the smaller kids and keep them entertained. The other option would be doing the free activities at the local library. I know that the library does, over by me, they do story time for, you know, the toddlers and the younger kids, and a lot of the libraries have free summer sessions or activities that they do. So that could be a really good option for you depending on where you're located and what age your kids are. If you're really looking for one of the cultural or educational experiences, we have a lot of great exhibits and museums around the valley. You can go visit the aquarium and butterfly exhibit in Scottsdale, or you can check out one of the local zoos. Now, that may be a little bit warmer because a lot of that stuff is outside, but it could be an option if it's maybe a cooler day, not quite so hot. You know, that might be a good day where you're like, hey, let's head to the zoo before it gets too hot, right? And then you can go to the Science Center in downtown Phoenix. You can check out the Phoenix Art Museum and the Children's Museum in downtown Phoenix area as well. And you'll really, you know, get that educational and cultural experience. Very cool spots that we have here. And, you know, if that's what you're into, then you'll have a great time doing that. The next thing you could do is make a summer long bucket list where you visit different ice cream and smoothie shops around the valley with your family. Maybe this is a once a month or a, you know, once a week thing where you go and check out a different spot. It will require some driving because the valley is so spread out and there's so many different places, but some of them have really cool options, and you know, this could be something really fun that the family looks forward to and does together and goes out, you know, once a week and hits a new spot. And, you know, it's an exciting adventure. It's a fun, cool treat and, you know, really fun, different thing for the family to do. Another great thing would be going to one of the local lakes. If you go to Lake Pleasant in Peoria or Bartlett Lake, if you're in the East Valley, this is a great way to stay cool. And, you know, you can go kayaking, boating, paddleboarding, just go and do a day trip and go and hang out on the beach. You know, our Arizona version of beaches, that's a great way to stay cool, get in the water, be in nature, and a really fun experience. I know Lake Pleasant even has a business that has these giant, crazy water slides that you can go do. They're pretty intense, but if you're adventurous, you'll probably have a blast. And there is the restaurant over on the dock at Lake Pleasant. You can rent gear if you need to, and it's a great way. We also do have, you know, some lakes and rivers up north if you're trying to escape the, you know, Phoenix area and you want to go up north and go camping and boating. You can, you know, stay by one of the lakes or one of the rivers, streams, and not feel like you're in the middle of the heat for a little while. It's a good way to cool down, get outdoors, get outside, and maybe just refresh from life in general. So that's always a fun experience, in my opinion, if you like, you know, to camp for a little while, get away from everything. And for the adults, if you want to get away for a spa day, that would be a really great thing to do during the summer. You're indoors, you're being pampered, taken care of. That would be a great thing. And you know, I mentioned Arizona Grand Resort and Spa earlier. They have that water park. If you want to go and check yourself in for a spa day over there, that is an awesome way to beat the heat during the summer and really take care of yourself. You could also, if you're looking for a little bit more adventure or you want to go outdoors, go Salt River tubing. That is such a fun and iconic Phoenix experience. It's worth the drive if you're in the West Valley to go all the way to the East Valley and go Salt River tubing. It's so much fun. My biggest recommendation though is to avoid the holiday weekends if you're looking to relax a little bit more, because those do tend to get a little bit rowdy and crowded during those time periods. But other than that, it's a great time. And always, I would say bring a towel, lots of water and sunscreen, and ropes, because you want your tubes gonna get really hot and you wanna stay connected to your group the whole time. So stay safe, but that's a great Phoenix summer experience for you. If you liked this video and you wanna see more, make sure you hit like so I know, and go comment in below and tell me what experience you're looking forward to during the summer here in Phoenix. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to this channel, because I'm gonna be releasing new videos every single week and I wanna make sure that you get notified so you can learn all about living and real estate, you know, what's going on with both of those in the Phoenix area and specifically the Northwest Valley. So thank you so much, and I will see you on the next video.